Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm hoping you guys are all having a fantastic day. So today's upload is going to be another one of those videos where I talk about the ongoing pattern of either summer, fall, or something like that, and how it's going to impact the fall and winter. And today's going to be why this summer's pattern indicates a cold and snowy fall 2019. So before you get down to the comment section box and you start rambling uselessly about how this is this never holds true, this is absolute garbage, this is absolute BS, let me tell you one thing. This video is not as clear-cut as some of the other ones in terms of where last video, I made a video about how a cold July may indicate a cold and snowy winter. That was fairly straightforward. If we have a cold July, then we're very likely to see a colder winter just based on that cold July. Obviously, there are so many other factors, but just based off that, pretty simple. In terms of this, why this summer's pattern indicates a cold and snowy fall, most signs show a cold and snowy fall if the summer is cold and wet. However, this is what the summer's pattern is. However, that's not what all the analogs are showing. Some of them do, some of them less so. So I just want to, tell you that this is not as clear cut as my other videos. Another little thing I want to say is I love you guys. Thank you so much for the recent support on my last videos. It really means a lot. And I thank you for that. If you'd like to subscribe, I always indicate or include a little subscribe after watching the video because, why would you subscribe before even knowing what the video is about? So watch the video, get it nowhere on this channel, and please consider doing so. I'm not making you, just I'm telling you, I'm advising you to consider. You could also like the video and leave a nice comment if you're willing to. And if you don't decide to subscribe and you still just want to watch a video, I love you equally as much. So right now we are looking at we are looking at a bunch of years. You could see these years probably seem familiar. Well, maybe not, but in my previous videos, I used these same years. These are the same years, the 2014, 2013. All those years are the ones with the cold summer or cold summer. Just a summer's pattern that is similar to this year's summer's pattern. So I took those years and I was like, okay, let's see what the September for all of those years looked like. You could see it was cooler across much of the east and south and parts of the north. The more west you go and north, northwestern areas were a little bit warmer. However, this wasn't a great anomaly. You could see 0.4, 0.6. So this is not horrendously, cold or horrendous warm. This is just very marginal, but it's still a difference, especially when it's indicated by these colors. So this is September of all those years. Let's go to October. This is October of the 2014, 2013, 2009. All those years had a cold similar pattern to this year. Pattern. So I basically, if you're confused on that, I found earlier in earlier videos summers that were similar to this year's summer, and summer's still not over, but we're getting a handle over it. We're getting a good sign that many of the same characteristics will happen as these summers have had. So you could see this is what October looked like for all those summers in terms of temperature. You could see that, October, not as clear-cut as September. Still cool, rather cool across the United States than warm, more cooler areas, but nothing remarkably cold. But still, this is more of the cold factor of the forecast, because to see it would have to be ridiculously cold in order to see snow in September or even October, early October for some locations. So the cold, this is more of like why this will indicate a cold fall. And but then look at November of all these years. I mean, ridiculous cold. Again, it's only 1 Celsius, but if it's marked by these colors, if the NOAA / ESRL Physical Science Division decides to put it in these colors, that means it made a huge impact. And you could see that all these years produced a very chilly November, and this is where the snowy side, I mean, if it's that cold in November across especially the north, then that's bound to produce quite a bit of snow with the precip that does fall. Now, you know, there's the other side of the factor. You know, we have the cold in November. Will there be a lot of precip? That is not as important, I think, and let me explain to you why. If it's, you know, in November, if it's November and it's this ridiculously cold, or the anomalies are pretty big in this part of the country where in November it usually starts snowing around here, if not way earlier, you could, you know, most of this will fall as snow. Whether there's going to be below average or above average, it's still going to be snowy because most of the rain that would fall on as rain on regular years would now fall as snow. So, you know, it could be 4 inches of snow and your average is 2 inches. So that's above average, but it could all be snow and no rain, so your precip could be below average, you know what I mean? It depends on, because the precip doesn't take in whether it's snow or rain, it's just all forms of precip, hail, sleet, freezing rain, I mean anything that falls from the sky as a form of liquid precip, or frozen precip, anything. So this is now the anomaly for all those years just combined September through November, because I showed you each separate month, and now I just wanted to show you the whole anomaly of the whole fall, September through November. And you could see the same exact years, I didn't switch it up, the same exact years, look at them right here, down here, those are the same exact years. And you could see very possibly a very chilly fall is on store with this. So you know, September through November, this is what could happen. And again, the first 2 months won't be as important in terms of the snowfall, because it would have to be insanely cold in order for there to be quite a bit of snow, you know, in September. But November, it doesn't, you know, it's only has to be marginally more chilly, and there will be some snow, you know. So I just, you know, even though the precip already explained why I don't think it matters as much, because I explained it, I still decided to show you some of it in the slides. Well, this is not the slide yet, but I'll show you in a couple of minutes what the precip looked like for these months. And it wasn't, you know, a below average or above average in any sort. It was kind of an average year, so that could still lead to a snowy year as long as we have the cold. And if we look at, now this is November of just a little bit different years. So you can see these years are basically when the July was cold. So I remember I did that video of, you know, what does a cold July mean? A cold winter, question mark? You know, this is what a cold July usually led to in November. Chillier across the south and a little bit warmer across the north. But I decided not to do July as the main forecasting point due to the fact that it's this video is going to be based on the summer's pattern, not July's pattern. And you know, if we look at September of all those years that had a cold July, you could see it was much warmer than that previous analog that I showed you for September. I mean, much of the country is in some kind of warmth, or not a single part of the country is below average, or it's either normal or above average. October got a little bit chillier across the southwest, still fairly warm across much of the country, though again, nothing you know, extraordinary, but still warmer than the previous analog I showed you. And then September through November of all those years was like this. So that, you know, if I were to make a video, what does a cold July mean? It means a lot less for the winter. I mean, you could see it's a lot more random. I mean, one cold July doesn't have to mean the whole summer was cool. But you could see that a cool July has a bigger impact on the winter rather than the fall. But a cold summer rather has a bigger impact on the fall and the winter. So very interesting stuff here. And in terms of the precip, now we're back to the years. Okay, guys, the video is gonna pause because this is what happens every time I go over 10 minutes. So there will be a short little interruption and I will be back. And this is gonna end in 3 seconds, 2 seconds, All right, guys, so we are back, and these are the years that, again, I showed you that had that very cold, that huge cold. Let me just go back. These years are the same years of this. You could see 2014, 2013, 2009, and this is the same thing. 2014, 2013, just in a different order. You could see 2014, 2009, 2013, 2004. That's because that's the way I typed it in. But you could see that the precipitation of the composite anomaly, the precipitation, nothing too remarkable. I mean, a little bit below average, or maybe across the north, quite a bit below average across the northwest, but everywhere else it seems more above average, though slightly, nothing too remarkable, but it's definitely still there. And again, if there was a cold November marked with a little bit cold, a more precip in some of those areas where it is cold, then you know, you're pretty bound to expect a snowy November or a snowy fall, since if it's a snowy fall, it's usually not remembered for October being snowy or September being snowy. It's usually November being snowy, because that's the only month of fall that most areas start seeing any type of snow that is respectable in amount. And this is now what is this? I think this is okay. Yeah, this is just the soil moisture. You could see I just decided to take several forms of this, and basically very similar. I mean, almost every single area is the same, just a little bit different amounts of variation in the deviance from normal. So you could see it's very similar, and then that's basically it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Consider liking the video if you want more of these videos. Consider subscribing, and I will catch you all guys on the next episode. See ya. Bye.